I revel in aesthetics and the marvels of nature. I'm a dreamer whose being is firmly rooted in reality, a reality often ugly, which I seek to make less so. Can I achieve this? Through my paintings and sculpting, I can but try.
Welcome to Escape Journeys magazine. I am Mahira Amir Khan. I am the co-founder and senior editor of the magazine. And I have an extraordinary woman with me today. She is an artist and sculptor from Pakistan. Thank you so much, Tabinda, for joining me.
Thank you. Thank you for having me here.
You're welcome. Let me tell you a little bit about Tabinda. Tabinda's works have been displayed in leading art galleries internationally, and she is actively involved in charitable organizations around the world. Is that right?
The organizations are Pakistani, but we have them around the world. Yes, we have functions, we hold balls, we hold various different types of functions in different countries, many different countries.
That's wonderful. And if I understand correctly, you were trained both in Pakistan and in England?
Yes. In fine arts, yes. Mm-hmm. Painting and sculpting both.
Another thing about Tabinda, she is the director of the Arts Council in Karachi, Pakistan. And she's also taught art appreciation in the Aga Khan University in Karachi. So I am so pleased to have you here with me. I'm so excited to hear about your spiritual journey and your tapestry of art and how that has actually inspired you to, as you've moved on in life.
Thank you. I believe in aesthetics, and I believe in the marvels of nature, and I would say I'm a dreamer. And I, there's this book coming out on my work, and it's called Between Dreams and Reality. Mm-hmm. And I chose those lines because that's what my paintings are about. They are between dreams and reality. You know, I feel that that reality can be very ugly. And dreams are there, but you have to work towards your dreams to make it, to make it a reality.
Yes, your art is so beautiful. What I love about the work that you do, mm-hmm. for example, the picture that's behind us right now, it's so vivid, it's so passionate and filled with color and life, and you bring in nature, for example, the bird and flowers, and there's a lot of emotion in the expressions. Why is it that there's such a focus on the human face and expression? What does that mean to you?
For me, coming from Pakistan, mm-hmm. A lot of our women are not allowed to even exist. I mean, they just are there. And I think everybody has some sort of, something more to offer to this world. It doesn't matter whether you're educated or you're not educated, but you could be very good at sewing, you could be very good at cooking, at anything extra rather than just looking after your family, which is a wonderful thing. But if you've got any other talent, you should be allowed to be able to express yourself and to be able to do that. And I really feel for the for the people, for the women especially, in many parts of this world. I mean, it's not just in the East, it's also in the West,
mm-hmm.
but I would say it's more in the East. And therefore, my paintings are just full of hope.
They are full of hope. That's what the colors about, the vibrancy and the birds seem to me to depict hope.
They do, yes. For me, a bird is freedom.
Yes.
A flower is something beautiful. And therefore, you know, I sort of depict these things in my paintings, because I feel that, you know, you should never give up. You should always have that hope, have that aspiration, have that dream.
Mm. What does it do for you to be able to sit down and splash color on a canvas and then come up with this beauty before you? What does it add to your life?
It just makes me feel fuller. It makes me more content. Because, you know, when I first started painting, I was depicting the world as it is. You know, I'd read the newspaper, it was all full of horrible things happening in this world. And I watched television, it was the same. So I was depicting all that in my paintings. They're very angry paintings. They were very ugly paintings. And they were just showing reality. I wanted to get away from reality. And therefore, I started dreaming. And in my dreams, I you know, felt like I felt much happier.
Mm-hmm.
And therefore, my paintings now are much happier paintings, because mm-hmm. that's what I want. That's what I want our world to be.
So coming from a country like Pakistan, I'm sure you've seen and experienced a lot of instability or life experiences that you've actually shared some with you, with myself, and it seems to me you've had a very intense, very passion-filled life yourself, and the art is almost a healing.
Yes, art, like writing, or like any of these things, it is very healing. You know, and I definitely am much happier when I'm painting, when I'm taking out all my emotions on the canvas. And sometimes it depends on my mood, and I paint accordingly. I try not to do that because I want to depict something which can be, not what is.
Mm-hmm.
But of course, being an artist and being emotive, having my feelings, I just flash out at times, and so the reality comes out, yes.
Yeah. When did you begin painting?
Well, I used to doodle, you know. I can't remember when. I was a little child since then. And my father used to take me to a lot of museums and art galleries all over the world. My mother used to go shopping. And my father and I used to go to all these places. I didn't quite appreciate it at that time because I was very young. I was 10, 11, 12. And I wanted to go and play around. I wanted to be more with my mother, do a bit of shopping.
Mm-hmm.
But much later, you know, when I was about 15, 16, 17 or so, I realized, I said, oh, I started appreciating what my father was doing, had done for me.
Mm-hmm.